Internal combustion engines have a relatively low efficiency of around 20%, give or take. That means that they produce a lot of waste heat, which can be used to heat their cabins in the winter. Electric motors are more efficient, which is good, except that it means you can't use waste heat because there isn't enough of it. You have to heat the cabin with electric resistance heaters. If you've ever turned on a hairdryer and watched the lights in your house dim, you understand that electric resistance heaters just chew through electricity. Since every watt that goes into heating the car or powering the headlights doesn't go into driving it, we've set an overall goal of cutting the non-driving energy needs of the car in half. There are two basic ways we can do this: by installing removable insulation, which the owner will take out in the summer, and by replacing lights with LEDs, a process we began back in part four.
So looking around the cabin for things that we can insulate, there's this little panel down here, which is depressed. And we can give it a little blanket. Everybody likes a safety blanket when they're depressed. We may be able to put stuff behind this door frame here. We're still discussing that. Might be able to put carpet on the floor or on the ceiling. We could put something that could be removed either with Velcro or a magnet. We're gonna take measurements now and then ask my mom to make a little quilt so that the car can have a hat. From front to back, 21 inches. The width of the back, counting the OSHA handle as part of the outside of the, God damn it. Call it 36 inches.
Wow.
Hey, so Michelangelo had the Sistine Chapel. This is the ceiling we are decorating.
Adding some fabric and a multi-layered piece of insulation here that can be removed with magnet. This will obviously be the outer layer. Then we could have a layer of Mylar under this. Now for backing, we could use something like cardboard, and then we could place magnets on it to stick it to the door.
We're going to the parts store for our car. Okay.
Don't get mad, LaCroix. We're drinking Polar today.
Steamboat.
I don't know what that's on there for. I've never heard it called that in my life.
So I'm just gonna kind of try to do a line of best fit. Beautifully drawn line here.
That's what I call the plausible deniability line. So if it doesn't work out, I can just say, oh, why didn't you follow the other line? Ceci n'est pas une pipe.
Now that we've got this in the shape we want it in, we're gonna trace.
So we're gonna also continue working on making the bottoms of the insides of the doors look prettier. Tom thinks it's gonna insulate something too, I kind of doubt it, but you know, this is a group project and we've all got our reasons for doing what we're doing.
Got our Mylar glued on the cardboard for the door panels, but we have a problem here. This is not gonna be compatible with a truck.
I think we just turn it into a motorhome and that solves our problem.
There we go.
Brought to you by LaCroix.
This is all glued into place. It's looking pretty good. We've got our cute queen magnets. If I have any problem, I can pulse contact them. Details on back. This is back. They're magnets. That's what we need.
Decided to use magnets to hold these on. That way they'll be removable. So here's the test. This is the second test of the day. We had the motor test. Now we have the decorative panel slash insulating panel test. I think it works. Look at that. That is handsome. Yeah. Door closes. Oh shit. We found a fix for this. All we did was just shove the top end of this into the door panel. Now it works. It actually looks pretty good.
I was testing the spray insulation and I just got it everywhere. This doesn't normally happen to me, I swear. We are testing to see how big the spray insulation gets to make sure that we don't put too much inside the door, giving us some time to set. It looks delicious, doesn't it? To further test the spray insulation, we're gonna see if it can pop open a sealed plastic container because we don't want it to. So Jason needs to finish the guacamole. This expands substantially. This is like all the way up to the top. It was like maybe 2 centimeters high when we started it. Anything that we put it in, it is going to expand.
ASMR.
This stuff expands too much and it would gunk up the inside of the doors. So what we're doing is we're making like removable pockets of insulation. We are going to weigh them down with this, filled it with weights, and it's going to go on top of these newspapers, which will prevent it from rising further than we want it to.
It's all very high tech and it will definitely work. This is our insulation in a bag.
Curdled pea flavor.
Its texture is slightly unsettling.
You know what? Caramel. Carmel. That's how we'll brand this.
This one. It just looks like a giant loogie. Like,
I've
just been collecting
yellow.
My saliva.
Oh, this is
after drinking coffee for a week.
These are the lungs of people who smoked marijuana and then got into car accidents. This is what happens if you check the donor thing on your driver's license form.
Yep, that's what happens.
We put them in our car.
You get reefer madness, you get a little crazy, end up in a tree somewhere, and then we get your lungs.
I actually think this might insulate.
In order to keep the heat out during the summer, Tom ordered this sunshade.
Well, I don't know how helpful this is gonna be.
Okay, now we're ready to go for a drive. We're aghast, now we gotta figure out how to get it back into the little bag.
So you basically just coil it, and you make like three loops out of it.
See, you learn anything on YouTube.
Some of our bulbs were labeled for off-road use, but we bought an ATV accelerator pedal too, so this is par for the course. Sometimes the expensive shit doesn't work and the cheap shit gets the job done.
These position lights took me a little while to figure out what they are because I ordered multiple different colors. Some of them are orange and some of them are white. Packaging for the different colors you would think would be a different color, but no, they are all red. The only indication that it was a different color, there was this single line that was underlined, and so I had to take this to my friend who speaks Japanese, and he said they had underlined the word orange. So that means these must be white.
This larger turn signal light is actually different. We thought it was going to be the same.
And it works.
Works.
Coming soon on eBay.
While these new LED lights do work, in that they turn on, the problem is they're too long, which means we can't use them.
This bulb was too long, this bulb is too long. This one has three contacts on the new one and only two on the old one. I thought about why that bulb had three contacts, and I realized that much like a high beam, a brake light is going to have two different modes, one brighter and one dimmer. The three contact bulb we have is the one that goes in here. We have definitely achieved an upgrade in brightness as well as efficiency. Some of the bulbs we have do work.
Is it okay?
Yep.
Tail lights and our turn signals are now much faster. We were laughing about these little resistors that you have to buy because the car gets tricked into thinking the bulb's burned out by the lower power draw on these LED bulbs. What that means is we have very eye-catching turn signals now. It's progress. We'll call it progress.
This piece wasn't attached in here. I'm probably just gonna hot glue it in place and try to think of something else to do later.
Mea culpa on the idea that the car was too dumb to notice that these were pulling less current, because watch what it does.
Somebody smacked the Acty in the back of the head and its eyeball fell out. We've got the headlights out again because we have these sexy LED headlights.
So we've got it in, but there's a problem in the form of this boot, because the boot has a little like thing in there that interferes with this little box here. We kind of want to leave the boot on because I think it's important for weatherproofing.
We are often making holes bigger, and today we've made this hole bigger.
They said trim the threaded bit.
Yeah, that is the threaded bit. But I need to thread that thing back on.
Oh, that thing has to go all the way
thing
through.
Thing that goes in here to hold it in. Yeah, probably just have to take all this threaded bit off.
Oh, all the threaded bit. Okay, yeah. So they mean trim the threaded bit off, not trim down the threaded bit.
Our circumcision was incomplete.
Mazel tov. This is almost there.
It's like one of those cats with two different colored eyes.
Yeah, we don't know where we put the bulb.
Well, we literally just had it here.
Well, I mean, this is a team effort. I don't know where the damn thing is. What we failed to realize is, even though this is sitting here, the other one is installed in the damn housing. So this is the second one. Oh,
That one's on.
This one is not on. They also interfere with the radio. So we installed the second one, turned it on to test it. The right side decided to blow a fuse.
In 2001, when the monkeys start playing with the obelisk.
Oh, you can see it crowning.
I think the only thing we're getting is from these little fans on the back of these LED.
Well, if the radio doesn't work, you can just use it to play a little song.
That's true.
Take things apart, we put them back together, we do it wrong, we take them apart again. I hope this is the last time we have to take these apart for a while. Hey, there they are. Visibility from these new lights is ridiculous.
So how'd we do? Pretty good. We still need to finish the front turn signals, door panels, and ceiling quilt, but we got a lot done. Now, while we could try to do some fancy math to find out how many watts we've saved by insulating the cab, there are too many guesses involved for our estimate to be really accurate. So, in a future video, we'll do an experiment to see just... goddammit. So, in a future video, we'll do an experiment to see just how much the insulation improves things. My guess is, after we finish the quilt, the cab will retain heat about 10% better. The lights are much easier to calculate. Since we have ordered our battery management system and know its constraints, we now know the final wattage of our basic drive system. We will have 32 3.2 volt batteries in series for a total of 102.4 volts. They are 100 amp hour cells, which means the batteries will give us 10,240 watt hours, or 10.2 kilowatt hours. We may increase the amp hours later by adding a second bank in parallel, but for now, this is going to be our basic system. With all the lights on, as incandescents, we would have been pulling 268 watts away from the motor. With all the lights on as LEDs, we will be pulling just 57 watts away from the motor, and the lights are more than 3 times brighter, too. Of course, you'll never have all the lights on at once, and some of them, like turn signals and the dome light, are only on rarely. For nighttime driving, we would use 145 watts for incandescents, or 41 watts for LEDs. That's a difference of 104 watts. Since our battery system gives us 10,240 watt-hours, if we used incandescent bulbs, we'd drain the battery in just 71 hours with the lights on going nowhere at night. How long would it take for LEDs to drain the batteries? 250 hours. We're still calculating the power consumption for the rest of the auxiliary bus, but LED lighting consumes about 29% as much power as the incandescents, and this significant reduction will play a role in sizing our DC to DC converter for charging the auxiliary battery. Among other things, that will make our converter cheaper. With our goal to cut non-drive system energy use in half, although we don't know the final figures for the insulation and heating yet, it seems likely that we will succeed. Show your support for mini trucks with a sticker from our store. We also have a GoFundMe. The links are in the description. And tune in next time when we'll be ordering a battery management system and also just generally fucking around.